Solomon Islands Prime Minister Manasseh Sogavare has ruled out any possibility of a Chinese military base in his country as the Pacific Islands Forum came to a colourful close this afternoon. Anthony Albanese selling Australia's climate strategy to regional leaders and spending big on a strategic telecommunications company.
No man or woman is an island, so in Fiji, it's a family affair. Complete with matching bulla shirts and a cheeky sledge about the origin result. Suna is exactly what the forum chair had wanted from Australia when it comes to combating climate change.
We cannot address these challenges on our own. We must work together.
Emerging from an all-day meeting behind closed doors, Anthony Albanese had managed to win the support of all leaders.
Australia's new position on climate change was particularly well received.
And after hugging it out with PM Manasseh Sogavare, Anthony Albanese's confident China won't be setting up a military base on the Solomon Islands.
I think you've got to deal with people at face value. I welcome his comments ruling out there being a Chinese base.
The PM making a clear indication his government plans on having a Pacific presence.
What we can do is engage, not just with the Solomons, but with all of our neighbours. That's something that was missing, frankly.
Climate change and COVID exacerbating vulnerabilities in a time of strategic competition between the US and China. The past few days here in Fiji have been all about communication, and today Australia took that to a whole new level. Telstra buying the Pacific's biggest telco, Digicel, with $2 billion of taxpayer money. The federal government denies it was to stop China's Huawei from getting there first.
No, this is about Telstra identifying a great commercial opportunity.
In the delicate dance of geopolitics, the summit ends with a new horizon. Chloe Bourris for 10 News First.